What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach, Elliot Scott. Just wanted to make a video real fast. I'm at my counter because I think this is an important topic to go over because I've seen it so many times this weekend. I've seen it with clients, seen it with in the comments, and I've seen it on my YouTube comments in chat, right? My live chat, okay? I cannot express the power of a woman pulling away. It's underrated. It is underrated. I have people, like I said, I had clients, I had comments, and I had chats where women said they pulled away or they did this tactic I told them to do, right, as a client or whatever, and the guy came coming back. I heard it today 3 times. Guy came back. I had a girl in the chat. I blocked the guy from everything. He won't leave me alone. I had another girl say that she left him. A week later, 2 weeks later, he came crawling back. Ladies, I want you to understand when you pull away from someone, there's a correct way of doing it. And I feel that a lot of you do it for the wrong reasons. And that's being, you're hoping he returns. You want to get a reaction out of him. Or things like that. When you should actually only be pulling away, in my opinion, when you're done. You're fed up. Okay? It has a stronger effect that way. It has a stronger effect when you're just like, I'm done with this bullshit. And you follow through with it. Because what usually happens is one of two things. You pull away and then you come back. And the guy is like, okay, well, I never have to worry about her leaving because she likes me too much. Hence why she came back. And two, you'll pull away, but the guy's not convinced you're actually pulling away. There's two types of pulling away. There's like, I'm going to do this no contact thing that Hussy and all these other dating coaches say. No, no, no. No contact means you are done. You are not reaching out unless he reaches out to you. You might as well think, I am never hearing from this guy again. Okay? But that's not what happens. A lot of the time, women don't follow through, or a guy's not convinced that you're actually done with him. It's not until he is convinced you're actually done that the feeling of regret starts to set in. That the feeling of regret starts to just like resonate and him be like, holy shit, I actually made a mistake. You have to get the guy to regret losing you. But you can only do that if you are actually willing to let go. They say the only thing you got to give up for your new life is your old one, right? But a lot of you aren't willing to do that for whatever reason. I don't know why you want to justify it. You want to see if it works. I understand you're afraid of doing it because you don't think he's going to come back around. You don't have any other options. You are afraid of being alone. You haven't talked to anyone in so long and it's COVID. And you're like, shit, and who knows how long this is going to go about, right? So if I let go of him, I don't care what your reasoning is, you gotta do it. And ladies, listen, I know I make videos on being like this high value chick, you know, I'm a boss ass bitch, like men need to bow. No, cut that shit out. That's not gonna happen. You're nothing fucking special. Hey, men and women, you're nothing special, okay? Like, don't be making this guy jump through loops just to make him jump through loops. It's reciprocal investment, okay? If he's investing in you, and you're investing in him, great. It only becomes a problem when you're investing over and over and over and over and over, and he's just reaping the benefits. And it becomes a problem when you don't say something, because then he just takes you for granted and takes advantage of you. You know, and the reason I'm bringing this up is because you're probably thinking, well, when's the right time to ignore him, or how should I ignore him? You should, again, if he doesn't text you tomorrow, that's fine. That's not a problem. You know, it becomes an issue when you have standards. He hasn't met them. You call him out for it, okay? And then he says, okay, I understand. And then he pulls the bullshit again. Then you need to start pulling back and say, hey, what's up, motherfucker? Like, right? Or did I even pull back? I hate talking about this because it's such an ego thing. People make it such an ego thing when it shouldn't be. It should just be a, hey, I gave you 2 chances or I gave you X amount of chances. I'm tired of it and I'm pulling back. You know, so I don't want you women to just, again, I hate it, man. There's so many YouTube videos out there, including mine, I think, where I make women, like, I talk about women being high value, but high value should be how you carry yourself and how you feel about yourself, not how men, you know, or not how you think men should treat you. That's a standard. Like, if you're like, I'm someone who values reciprocation, I'm someone who values communication and clarity, okay, awesome. But if you're some girl who's gonna try to get a guy to jump through a bunch of loops just to do it, that's just games. That's just mind games. No guy's gonna play with that, because guess what? Whatever you're offering a guy, someone else can do it, or someone else can offer him the same thing and not make him jump through loops. Just be a normal human being who likes you, you know, where they like each other and they just have a reciprocal investment. It's all about reciprocal investment. If he is investing in you and you are investing in him and things are going well and you're both happy, healthy, ego people who don't have any emotional unavailability, and you're both looking for a relationship, things should go smoothly, okay? But if they don't, then you're going to start seeing some cracks. Like I said, this guy is going to take you for granted. He's going to love bomb you, show you a lot of effort in the beginning, and then it dies off, and or he's going to take you for granted, something like that. And when that starts to happen, you need to say, hey, I understand things have been a little different. Are you okay? You're not as enthusiastic as you were last week or 2 weeks ago. What's up? Oh, just work. I'm sorry. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, I understand that. I'm not asking for marriage. I just want a little more reciprocation. Is that too much to ask? Is that a problem? You know, whatever. Oh, no, I understand. That's fine. Yeah. And then let's say he does it, and he does it for a little bit, and then it dies off. And you're like, okay, we got another problem, homie. And again, this has to be realistic expectations. If you're trying to talk to the guy all day, every day, you ain't going to get that shit, at least from me or not. But if it dies off again, then you gotta say, dude, what's up, man? What's up? Don't say it like that, obviously. Have a talk with him again. And if he can't follow through, then this is what I call a character flaw. It's not you, it's just a character flaw. I mean, it might be you. Maybe he's just not attracted to you, or maybe he just doesn't want a relationship right now. Whatever. Then you guys are just on different pages and you cut your losses. But that's when you start to do it. You just don't ignore a guy to ignore a guy, ladies, okay? So with that being said, I love you all. Take care and peace.